Hello everyone. Today in this video, I will show you how I replace the front differential axle seal on the 2008 Ram 2500. So let's go remove the two front tires because I have to pull the axle shaft out. So you can see the axle seal leaking on that side on the tires. So next step is remove the tie rod end nut and brake caliper with the bracket, remove the brake rotor and axle nut. So taking the tie rod end, outer tie rod end nuts out and tap with hammer. So easy to turn the knuckle to take the brake caliper bracket assembly with the brake pad and hang it to the side and disconnect the ABS wiring connector behind the wheel well. And after I going to open the differential cover to drain the fluid before I continue to make sure that I need the gasket, I can order it. So gasket is look fine to me and I can reuse, I can clean and put the silicone gasket on. And now going to remove the bearing with the four bolt on both end, front and back. So with the impact gun it's easy to remove those bolt. So two bolt in the front and two in behind at the rear, and remove the quarter pin to take the axle nut out. And use a hammer to tap a little bit, make sure that axle shaft is not kind of like seize up into the bearing. So apply a little bit of W-40 and just very lightly tap on the bearing so it's come out easy, just like that. And now going to remove the axle shaft with the pry bar to the housing, just pry it a little bit and it will come out very easy. Just like that. And on the passenger side, the process is the same as the driver side. So now next step, going to remove the differential gear assembly by removing the bolt to hold the adjuster lock. So two small bolt to take the two adjuster lock out from both sides of the side bearing adjuster. And I use a paint marker to mark on the adjuster, make sure the adjuster not move. And next step, remove or loose four bolt for the side bearing cap. And hold the gear and remove the bearing cap. And use a small punch to punch two little holes to punch to make the mark on the adjuster in case the paint that I put on there will be clean off and it's hard for me to find, take longer to adjust the bearing after. So I back off the adjuster one turn to pull the gear assembly out from the housing. That's the bearing caps on both sides. And pull the gear assembly out. Just like that. So the adjuster, I back off one turn. Now I have to count how many turns until it fully out. So when I'm ready to put back the adjuster, I just go in the same turn again and go one turn toward the bearing to tight free load the bearing. I only do one side so I don't mess up the gear backlash between the ring gear and the pinion gear. So next step, going to remove the seal with the seal removal, but I can't really, because if I try to do that with the seal removal or with the pry bar like that, I will hit again the housing where the very fine and small thread for the adjuster to go in. So if I damage that thread, it's going to be trouble for me to put the adjuster back in later. So I use a pry bar to tap to pop the seal out from the other end from the steering knuckle. So the seal like two pieces. So one inner piece is out and the outer piece is a little bit hard to use a pry bar to tap on the metal part. So I have to break the hard plastic. It's also part of the seal, so break that plastic out so I can use the pry bar to push on the metal part and pop the seal out. Now after clean the housing very good and ready to install the new seal with the seal installer. I have so many different sides of that installer, so get the correct side and just tap the seal in like that. It's very easy to tap the seal into the housing. So yeah, just like that. And final check, just make sure the seal it sit flush into the housing, looking very good. Now next step, put a little bit of lube on to the adjuster thread and find that two dot that I made earlier, and now start from there. I screw in the adjuster into the housing there. So I'm screwed in 8 turns, just like when I remove it. And from there, lubricate the bearing housing and ready to put the gear assembly back. So when I put the gear assembly in place, I didn't touch the adjuster on the left side so I don't mess the gear backlash between the ring gear and the pinion gear. So when the housing go back in place, put the bearing cap on, just finger tight, make sure the gear is still moving side to side, in and out a little bit. Just finger tight the bearing cap bolts, and turn the adjuster one turn toward the bearing to preload the bearing. And while I doing that, I turn the gear assembly. I didn't have video to show you guys, but that's how I tighten the adjuster and preload the bearing one turn, just like when I remove it out earlier. And after that, put the adjuster back in place and put the bolt in. So now ready to tighten to torque the bearing cap to the spec. 74 foot-pound. Check in the computer, they have two different sides of the gear assembly. So I go with the higher one. And now tighten the locking, the adjuster locking bolt. Yeah, just like that. And now it's ready to put the actual shaft back in. So make sure when we put the actual shaft in, the end of the shaft is not dragging at the bottom of the housing because it's rusty and a lot of dirt. Try to clean it up, but it's not coming out easy. So just kind of lift the end of the shaft a little bit so it's not touching the bottom of the assembly. And use the pry bar, try to give a little bit of push of the shaft in. Looks good on the inside. So the long shaft on the passenger side, the same thing. Try to keep the end of the shaft up in the center of the housing when we push it in. And same thing, use the pry bar to pry it in. Very easy to go back in. Just like that. Yep, so both of the shaft in. And ready to put the cover back on. After I put the silicone gasket onto both sides of the gasket and put the bolt back in, and you can do with hand tight all those bolts or torque it up and put the gear oil into the differential. So that's all. The rest is easy and straightforward to put back in. So thank you so much for watching. If you find this video helpful, and please subscribe to the channel for more videos like this. Thank you so much and have a great day.